Why do I do what I do? My purpose in life is to help unlock the greatness in others. How do I do that? I created something I call the Unauthorized Biography Series, where I tell the life stories of the world's greatest leaders, heroes, all through biographical rap songs, repackaging history through hip-hop.
My name is Shaun Boothe, but I am a hip-hop artist coming all the way from Toronto, cold Toronto, Canada. Do you have any hip-hop fans in the crowd?
You see, we live in a world where more and more now, all the breaking news is heartbreaking news or hateful views, racial feuds. And we gotta watch out because we turn into what we tune into. That's why I look to the greats to understand what it took to be great. And as I perform and share these stories, my question is always, what can we learn? What can they teach us about leadership, community, greatness?
Looking back, they said Martin walked so Obama could run. Three dots, cause his legacy had just begun.
Legacy. What could Muhammad Ali say about that? Was the greatest of all time fighting for applause or fighting for a cause?
They said go to jail or go to Vietnam. And they took his title, his boxing license. And he took it to court and fought 3 years long. And somewhere in that time, America realized the world was wrong. And he went from traitor to hero. And in a year or so, he was coming back strong.
And Oprah Winfrey, what can she teach us about faith, perseverance, or about rising above our circumstances to design our own life?
But even as a little girl, she knew that she would conquer the world. Not a Coke bottle in a dress, but still America's top model for success.
Or what about the godfather of soul, James Brown? Legendary talent, but produced by an even more legendary work ethic.
They've never seen feet that quick or the elaborate theatrics that he patented. Like the cape routine, even the way he screamed became a part of his personal trademark. But he wasn't nationally known till after he released the live at the Apollo LP, the 63. But originally, the label didn't see it selling. He was like, why chance it? So he financed it. And before you knew it, it was gigantic. Made the cost to be the boss, he said. And later on, it became one of his songs.
Or what about a biracial Bob Marley and his message of one love? Almost losing his life in an assassination attempt, trying to unite his divided country, what can he teach us about unity, love, and how when it's all said and done, we are all one?
Either way, that's where he grew up from then on, in the slums, with the squatters. Oddly, he grew very far. But little man had to be strong, cause in his day it was a disgrace to be mixed race. He always had to keep his fists raised. You're not gonna sway no votes, singing songs, away you go.
He was left for dead, but there were none braver. And then finally, 2 days later,
arm in the sling, he got a
from
sling.
Nobel Peace Prize winner Malala Yousafzai to Tupac Shakur, more than just a presentation, it's a celebration and a chance to learn from the greats. Their footprints, your blueprint.